And then the next scan that we have, there's the warning, and you can see it even more impressive.
And what's the location there?
Signature. That's right over our heads right here at Hampton Elementary, basically.
Not only was Ryan Ellis one of the ones to issue the tornado warning, he was on the scene to survey the damage the very next day.
You had all of these power lines were down across the road, pieces of roof, cars everywhere, people just kind of walking each direction, kind of in a fog.
No one died from the tornado. Three people were injured. It's a miracle when you consider tornadoes this big and dangerous almost never happen in central North Carolina. A high-end EF2 with winds close to 140 miles per hour that touched down in downtown Greensboro stayed on the ground for 33 miles, 16 of those in heavily populated Guilford County.
It's almost like a pit in your stomach, especially knowing exactly where that was happening, right over downtown, because we knew from that point on we had very little time to get the warning out to the public.
People in the path of this tornado would have 2 to 5 minutes to seek safety. This advanced warning may not seem like much, but if you have your plan in place, you can get to safety in less than a minute.
We asked, did they get the warning? And in this area in particular, everybody said, yeah, we got the warning. We were able to get to our safe place, and boy, we are lucky to be alive.
That was not the case in 1936, when 17 people died and 44 were injured, when an eerily similar tornado moved through downtown Greensboro. Now, meteorologists have advances in technology to see a storm's threat sooner and in more detail. Reflectivity images show heavy rain and may show the familiar hook echo. This one did not, because it was buried in heavy squall line rain. So other technology is needed, and for that we use velocity images. Those red and green squares that allow us to see inbound and outbound winds, showing us the center of rotation. Sometimes though, that rotation can be several thousand feet off the ground and may never touch down. And in this case, that was happening all day long in the southeast.
We had seen probably 10 to 20 storms already on this day that look exactly like this.
So no warning yet?
No warning yet.
Because you'd seen it.
Yep, we've seen it. And then the next scan, you can see it starting to tighten up quite a bit. And then, boom, right there.
Yep. The velocity images then showed tightening of the rotation. That's when the tornado warning was issued.
We now have a tornado warning. It is out for Guilford County. Now this storm.
And then a relatively new piece of warning technology confirmed what radar operators feared.
The scan before, you don't see it. So the warning was out, and then there it is,
wow.
Right there. So literally just a couple of minutes for people to get to their safe place. And
what Ryan saw was a ball of debris the tornado had picked up. It showed up blue on this correlation coefficient image. It measures the size of things in the air, like raindrops, hail, and in this case, debris. This allows meteorologists to issue further statements to media meteorologists like me that this is a radar-confirmed tornado, and it's on the ground in downtown Greensboro, just north of Business 85.
So this would be intense rotation for our part of the country.
And that's when the hair on the back of my neck stands on end. And I know what I have to do. Quickly, thoroughly, and calmly, I relay street names and the location of this destructive tornado while telling people where to go to be safe.
That's the pit in your stomach, because this is one of the best signatures I've ever seen of the debris, which means there's a lot.
I knew we were going to have damage, and unfortunately, a lot of it. I just hope that our message was getting out to the people in its path and they were in their safe place. I'm almost holding my breath, and then the damage reports start coming into the newsroom.
I've been doing this over 25 years, and this looks like a tornado.
The most remarkable damage story Ryan heard the next day was from a family in a turn of the 20th century home.
And they actually found their relative about 100 yards away, sitting propped up next to a washing machine that was in the house, and they're all alive.
And the woman in this now rebuilt home is alive too. Last year, only one wall remained. She was in the tub with a mattress on top of her, doing just what meteorologists like Ryan and I teach on television, in schools, and in seminars every week of the year.
That protection of life is the most rewarding thing, and when you can come directly to the community, speak directly to that person, look in their eye, and they say, not only did they get the warning, but they knew what to do. Right. Maybe their parents didn't have it, but now their kid has told them, and maybe someday that piece of information saves their life.
No lives were lost in the tornado that day, but lives were forever changed. And some of the physical structures are still in disrepair. It's a long road to recovery, to put back together what Mother Nature tore apart in just a few minutes.
On that day, you knew that even if it did take a year, 2 years, they were gonna stick together and they were gonna come back.